Hi, family. We are continuing in our lessons that work on applying what we've studied together. We're focusing on our theme, living with purpose, on purpose, and in particular, the third point of that sermon, I exist to participate in the will of God. How does one make application of the notion that you exist to participate in the will of God? Well, think about the ramifications of knowing that your every breath is one that is given because ultimately it's facilitating a life that was gifted to live for a purpose bigger than the universe. Meaning what? Meaning that God has called every one of us, every believer, every disciple, He's called us to Him with one amazing agenda to reconcile others into the family of God. The Apostle Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, now all these things are from God who reconciled us to Himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation, namely that God was in Christ reconciling the world to Himself, not counting their trespasses against them. And He has committed to us the word of reconciliation. Therefore, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were making an appeal through us. We beg you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. That is a beautiful passage, and it helps us to see that there are at least four ways that we really flesh this out. Four things that we can walk in making application of what it means to exist, to partner with God for His will. Number one, you ought to carry with you the fact that you walk with, we walk with an authority that's given by God. By nature of being His children, we walk with and by the power of the Word of God. And that Word is in opposition to false narratives and falsehoods that would tell people lies straight from the enemy himself. We carry with us the power of the Word of God. Hebrews 4 and verse number 12, it is living and powerful. We carry the power of the gospel of Christ. Romans 1 verse number 16, that word is able to change hearts. We carry with us the ability for God to dynamically move against life itself. James 1 and verse number 21. So walk in that. Walk in the authority of the Word of God. But not only are you walking in the authority of the Word of God, remember, as Paul describes, we are ambassadors. And since we are ambassadors, one of the things we ought to remember is that we're not from here. An ambassador is sent from one place to the next, from one nation into another nation. And that's an image that we ought to carry with ourselves. How often do you find yourself, I know I do, being caught in or intoxicated with a world that isn't even your home? Remember that you are an ambassador. As the songwriter says, this world is not my home. We really are just passing through. But as an ambassador, we come with the authority of the one who sent us, and we come with an assignment to represent our home. So walk in your authority, walk as an ambassador. And let me give you a third thing that ought to help you to make application. You come with an appeal. Paul says in this text at verse number 18, that as ambassadors, we appeal to the world around us to be reconciled. Well, we carry an appeal also. And our appeal, this is especially for those of you that would say, I don't have all the verses and I don't know everything from the book of Acts all the way to the book of Revelation. And I'm not real eloquent or erudite or proficient throughout the scriptures. Can I just share with you one thing? For every one of us, there is another one of us just like us waiting to meet us. What you do have, even if you're not as competent as you want to be in the Word of God, is you have a testimony of what God has done for you. Carry that appeal. Someone wants to hear that God is relevant and God is real and God is powerful in your story on how God redeemed you, your story on how God is keeping you, your story on how God maintains you may be just the blessing that someone else needs to hear. So carry that. Walk in the authority of God's word. Walk as an ambassador. Walk with an appeal to share your story with someone else. And let me give you one more. Walk in the knowledge of knowing that your very life and all of what you do by way of ministry is with the assistance of God. Think about how powerful it is that your God desires to be a co-laborer with you in His agenda. God is really saying, I do all of the heavy lifting. I will assist you as you walk out as an ambassador. I will assist you as you share with boldness. I will assist you as you make an impact in other people's lives. That's your challenge. Your challenge is to remember that you exist in order to partner with God in His will. And in that existence, I want to challenge you to walk in the authority, walk as an ambassador, walk with the appeal, and walk in the assistance of God to execute this very purpose in your life. Let me remind you of one more thing. Subscribe to the channel, share it with those that you think is relevant, and click the down arrow to get the notes, and you'll be able to follow every verse that's referenced in this text. Listen, I'm going to pray for you. You pray for me. And let's watch God change everything around us. God bless you.